know Greek.
You know Greek?
Okay. And now, when I use the Bible against you, you cannot say, you cannot use it against me because why you have to know Greek. You cannot say that.
You know
Hebrew.
Yeah.
Okay. You know Hebrew.
And now, can I ask you something, you higher?
I've never said that.
No, yeah, yeah, no, no, he was saying that.
You said,
you said no, that's it.
Let me elaborate. I have never said, or Christians don't generally say.
So they don't say it.
We don't say that you need to know Greek or Hebrew to be a Christian or to understand our faith. What the faith is based on is just is the message. It's the message, not so much the word. Whereas when you go to Islam, Islam is, if you like, the word verbatim from Allah. So every word ought to be perfect. Every word, there can't be any flaws. There can't be any faults because it's verbatim from Allah. Okay, like, as dictated to Gabriel, Gabriel gives it to Muhammad.
Yeah.
So my question to you.
No, 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 baby, no, no.
you know, Christians.
No, no, ask me.
You know, Christians.
No, 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 no. Ask me a question.
No, no, I haven't asked a question.
No, no, but
I just responded to your question.
I know,
just,
I know. Yes.
One question,
Goodwin.
No, but wait, I'm asking you a question.
Don't waffle.
You came in.
Don't waffle, Goodwin.
No, no,
you asked me a question.
No, no,
I answered. You said, do I speak Greek?
No.
Did he say right? But and then I responded to it and I elaborated. Now I want my question.
What did he ask you?
No, no, wait.
I've got a question.
What did I ask you?
Ask me.
No, why did I ask you?
Why?
How do I know if you're high
school? You
because I responded.
No.
I responded, right?
Let us to understand.
That's why I
speak him and the other guy, right?
I'm saying,
if you allow me to speak to understand why.
Godwin, relax, right?
So can I ask you a question?
You can, but as long as I explain something to understand. He said the Christians always say you cannot use the Bible, you have to know Greek. Correct?
Christians say that?
No, no, he said people are saying that. So you came, because listen, you came in, you said no, you don't have to become a Christian, you don't have to know Greek to become a Christian. Likewise for Islam, you don't have to know Arabic to become a Muslim. However, to explain the Quran, you have to explain, you have to know the rules of the Arabic language. Likewise, you have to know the prophetic tradition. Likewise, you have to know what the companion said. Because within the Quran, it gives us a guideline to understand it. Is it saving with the Bible?
No.
Okay, so now you've asked me a question again.
Okay, ask your question. No,
okay,
ask
so my question is this, yeah. Right? So, I'm going to keep it relative. I'm going to keep it to the point. So,
you've got another company.
My question is this.
No.
Should
we leave or leave? No, I don't like to be next to a liar, the biggest liar against Prophet Muhammad. I don't know.
And you know
people
what?
No,
obviously, it's revealed in Arabic.
Yeah.
Can we understand every word of the Quran?
Allah said, of course, this argument. No, this argument, he was speaking to a brother in his channel.
Yes.
He comes to the wrong guy now, yes? Everyone, there is no one in the Muslim scholars does not understand. We can understand everything in the Quran. Why?
You can, yes.
So you can.
Those words that I mentioned.
Just wait, Goodwin. Don't interrupt.
No, no.
Don't interrupt.
Wait. Because I can't remember the word you mentioned.
Sorry, give it to you again.
Give it to me. Watch.
Okay.
Oh,
so this is
guy, man.
Because what he's coming with, that in the Quran he has no there's different type of explanation. There's explanation that we can understand.
So verse one. This
yes. Kaf haya insad. Okay. Kaf haya insad. This the letters. Okay. This Allah reviewed these verses and these letters. When Allah challenged the Arab to bring something like the Quran, the Arabs start pretending they don't understand the Quran that was recited unto them. So Allah start putting the letters of the Arabic alphabet in the beginning of the Quran to show them the Quran that Prophet Muhammad is reciting is made up, or let me use the correct one, it's consistent. So he's not going
to
be happy with it.
It's
consistent, but it consists the letters of what? Of the Arabic alphabet. For example, imagine I bring a poem in English language and clearly everyone can see I'm speaking English. But the guy I'm challenging, he will say, no, that's not English. So I'll tell him, okay, A, B, C, D, E. Then I will say the poems.
Yeah.
So therefore, those poems are made up of those letters, which Jesus just agreed with me, is what? English letters. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged them. Who said that? Imam al-Shinqiti, may Allah have mercy upon him. Who said that? Ibn Taymiyyah before him. Who said that? The companions. That's what I said to him. In order to understand the Quran, you have to go back to companions. They answer your question.
Okay. Let me.
No, no, no. Did he answer your question?
I said yes.
Did he answer your question?
Ask your question.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes or no?
Answer the wrong question.
Ah, okay, look after yourself.
No, I'm not gonna run.
You ask the question. I don't want to answer it.
Okay.
That's all right. You don't like to answer.
I want to answer. She's speaking. That's your question.
Let's just speak.
No, let's speak.
You want to preach?
Let's be quiet. Come. Come.
What are you running for?
I'm running. I'm gonna
listen, say okay. So by him just making up, waffling for 5 minutes, means that he's answered the question.
No, he answered. He answered the question. Goodwin.
Shamsi, you're
Goodwin, you answered your question.
Goodwin, you know why? Because I answered the question, therefore clearly you're not really here to learn the answer. You are here to debate.
You're not here to learn.
No, you're lying.
I'm lying. Show me which Muslim scholar said that. No. Show me which Muslim scholar said that.
Let's read
where you are lying.
Okay, good.
Let's read it.
Okay, I'm back around.
No,
you
just
read
it.
Okay,
the message. You don't need to help him. Why are you helping him for?
These are among the 14 opening letters which occurred in various combinations.
Who's speaking? This translator.
Wait!
Who is running? No, I want you to answer the question.
I answered it. You're not happy with it.
You're not happy with it. Good for you. No, see,
Can you read in Arabic?
These are among the 14 opening letters which occur in various combinations at the beginning of 29 surahs in the Quran. Although there has been much speculation as to their meaning, it was not in fact revealed by Allah to anyone. And is known only.
Name the scholar. Godwin, answer me. Which scholar said that?
I'm going to respond.
Go on.
Just wait a minute. Okay. So I've just read from you.
Yes, I understand that. Which scholar said that?
So I'm going to give it to you.
Yes, go on.
Okay.
Let him check the book. He doesn't even know.
Hold on, everyone keep quiet.
Hold on,
Barakallahu feekum. Now we're exposing him. Okay. He's in a commentary of a person and he said, I'm a lion. So, no, I'm not.
Why are you trying to throw a red herring?
Okay,
I asked him a question.
He
says,
that the Quran is a pure Arabic and we can understand
it? Said that?
It's a simple question. Can we understand
the Quran? I asked this question. Then he said, I'm wrong. Why?
He does
because
not
the
scholar answer.
Said this. I'm asking him who's the scholar.
He's not answering. But he, and then he was ready to run. And so I come back. See, now he's running. Now he's running. Keep running, Islamic Dawah team. Keep running, Islamic Dawah team.
He said, I'm running. So what I do, because I know there's no point speaking to him. But for this faith, for the sake of showing people that we don't run away from the liars. I quote Ibn Taymiyyah, a Muslim scholar. I quote Ibn al-Qayyim, a Muslim scholar. I quote Al-Shanqiti, a Muslim scholar. I quote Ibn
Where's the spoon?
Come here.
This spoon from here, make sure
you are you at him?
Yeah. So, all right. Here again, we're trying to engage with the Islamic Dawah team. Shamsi, an imam, is a prominent member of this Islamic Dawah team. I want to ask him simple questions. If this Quran is the perfect word of Allah, and Allah cannot contradict himself, and Allah is a great communicator, don't worry too much about him.
He's a great
communicator. The question you have to ask yourself is this, is that why can we not understand it, the words within the Quran? And this is the question I asked him. And so I'm showing verses that they're not able to respond to. Now, when we look at what the Quran says, in the commentary on the Quran, it states that nobody knows what these words say. Scholars from the world cannot affirm what these words in the Quran say, but yet it's from Allah, given to mankind, and we're supposed to be able to understand the Quran because Allah revealed it to Muhammad to mankind. And so what happens again? They run away. That's them. They're running away.
Can you tell us, a Muslim scholar?
They're running away.
Can you tell us, a Muslim scholar?
They're running away.
I'm here. I'm running away. Can you tell us, a Muslim scholar said it?
Once again,
Godwin, which Muslim scholar said it? Godwin, which Muslim scholar? Go get it. I'm waiting for you.
Once again,
go get the book.
So,
Godwin, you said the Muslim scholar said it. Do you have the name? Do you have the name, Godwin? Godwin, stop running.
Let me tell
stop
you.
Stop running, Godwin. Stop running. Godwin, say the name.
No one is running.
Say the name. Everyone, say the name.
Okay.
Say the name. So, say the name.
What? Shamsi has
said the name.
Once again. See, now he's running.
He doesn't have the name.
Now he's running again. Shamsi's running again.
You have the name. You have the name.
Now, what? Shamsi is meant to be an imam.
Everyone, the Muslims, leave him.
Just leave him. He can't ask. He's running again. Oh, there he goes. Are you running?
He said the Muslim scholar said it. Put it on your camera. I ask him who's a Muslim scholar. No name. He's still talking.
The question is this. See that he's running. How many times can you run in one day?
I will take over.
That's the fifth time he's running.
I will take over.
So, I'm going to continue.
I'm going to take over.
Once again, we have the Islamic Dawah team who will not engage. All they will do is find red herrings.
From Genesis of the Nation, read the Quran, and
they're running again. They're running again.
You never have a chance against Muslims here.
Okay.
Because
so
now we'll your
maybe,
Bible.
Maybe this. Let me ask you one question. Maybe this guy will answer.
No.
Let me ask you one question.
I want a proper debate.
Are you going to answer my question?
Yeah. Proper debate.
Are you going to answer the question Shamsi could answer?
No question. Proper debate.
Are you going to answer the question Shamsi?
No question.
He doesn't want no question.
You're ordered.
So here we go. We got another Muslim runner.
Ask him questions. Can I ask you questions?
No. So I was debating with Shamsi.
Yes, yeah, so what?
You've just said on record.
What did I say?
But I will take over from Shamsi.
Yeah.
You just said that. So, can you answer the same questions I just asked to Shamsi? Can you answer the same question I just asked to Shamsi?
I offered £500.
See?
He wrote a question.
He can't answer. He will not answer. He will not give me a yes. He will not give me a no.
Go on YouTube.
See what I'm saying to you? Islamic Dawah team are infamous for attacking Christians, but they will not respond.
Who
engage them on their own Quran?
Never a chance.
So,
how many YouTube?
Keep running.
Every week you lose.
Keep running.
Every week.
They can't answer.
No, we are inviting to Islam.
Okay.
The religion, all the
so
prophets.
Can you answer the question?
All the prophets are Muslims.
Can you answer the
no
question?
No question, debate.
You won't answer about your own religion.
I can ask you.
How comes the Muslims come to Speaker's Corner
to
give dawah?
Listen to me.
And when we question them about the dawah they're giving, they start running. Why are Muslims running from Christians when they come to tell us to come to this perfect religion of Islam?
Proper debate.
Here I
freed. They're cowards.
No, in Islam.
They deceive.
It's Tawheed.
And this
what
is
of
what
God.
We have once again.
It's also in the Bible.
We have Muslims who are constantly
all
running.
The only one
why?
God.
Why are they running? Because Islam
no, you can ask me question. Look.
Is indefensible.
You can ask me question. Let's debate.
Islam.
No, let's debate first.
It's false. Islam is full of lies. Muhammad is a false prophet. And so, this is why they're constantly running. They're waffling.
I won't even open
they're
it.
They're lying.
Debate.
They will not you address
see,
the issues of Islam.
And so,
don't tell me.
This is a prophet I saw in the Bible.
One touch.
So once again,
the prophet I saw in the Messiah.
The Muslims see, are running.
Ask me questions.
So, this brother asked to me, I will take over from Shamsa.
How do you get 100 pounds?
He will know.
Daniel, 200 pounds.
So we'll leave it there.
300.